California State Spelling Bee, and I'm glad to be here. H-E-R-E, here. inside jokes. Listen, I've been reading about our foreign policy. I thought in case you missed it, I'd bring it home to you. And it's tremendous. We have a deal now where we lose the countries, but we retain the leaders. That's the part I wanted to tell you about. thank you, pockets of resistance. President Kennedy, as you know, was in Paris where nothing happened, I mean eventful. He got off the plane and said, take me to your leader. That's the report here. And there was a lot of confusion at that order. And then he got back in the plane and went to Vienna where he said he'd meet with Khrushchev until they reached an agreement or until his term of office expired, whichever comes first. And then went back into the plane and is reported to have said to his wife, what did you do? And she said, I went shopping. I got a Dior and a Cassini. And the president said, may I see them? And Mrs. Kennedy said, yes, they're in the aft part of the plane designing dresses. That's the report as far as I have it. The vice president is in Laos. Are you aware of Laos? Well, it'd be easier if I could tell you who the leader was there, but we haven't chosen him yet. So we'll have to deal with the country as an abstract geographically. The vice president over there, Lyndon Johnson, as you know, and said that he had some good news, and that is that the Chinese are ready for a rebellion if we give them some encouragement. Where did you get this information? It was a Cuban fellow who went by. That was all that happened with him. The vice president, the former vice president, Richard Nixon, lives in my hometown now, Los Angeles, where he's a lawyer. He's with this company, and they followed a good taste principle of not mentioning his name. It's not, they don't want to trade in on it. So it's not on the letterhead. You just kind of see him in the office when you go back and forth, and you say, wasn't that? And they say, no. Everybody used to look like that once. And Mr. Nixon, as you know, went out and got a job. He left the political fires to burn and made an application for a law firm in California, which said, I think, what was your last position? And I think he said, vice president. And they said, how long did you hold it? And he wrote, 8 years. And then it said, why did you leave? It was left blank temporarily while I worked out. Anyway, I have some other opinions. I've been leaving them in magazines recently. Last month, some of you saw an article in Playboy magazine about comedy, if you read the articles. It's a magazine you may have seen. There's a girl in the middle you can take out and assemble. Understand, it's part of the folklore. An article about comedy, and then I did one for Time magazine about the Central Intelligence Agency. They talked to me because I followed their activities. They followed mine, so we're even. I want to make that clear over the years. And then this month, in an effort to get away from politics and comedy in general, I did an article for the Ladies Home Journal, which will be appearing soon between the recipes and Mrs. Kennedy, I imagine. Anyway, it'll be in there in a couple of issues, and it's about the subject of women. This is the first time I've talked about women on the stage since I was a teaching assistant at the University of California. That was 8 years ago, and at that time, I had a section in the math department, which is very difficult, and I was trying to teach them about approaching an object mathematically, except they didn't want to approach it. Most of them were asleep in the class. So I made the, they haven't changed. I made the object a woman on a couch, and I made a guy approaching her on her couch. You see, because in the math department, you're always halfway to an object until you reach her. That's in the math department. In the philosophy department, you never reach her. I want to make that clear. And in the psychology department, you find out that she was no good for you anyway. Now, the only other good news I have is that Governor Rockefeller has signed a bill so that any time an investigating committee goes after anybody for subversive activity and they take the Fifth Amendment, they can't get a driver's license here in New York. So, that's right, he signed. If you see anybody now with a chauffeur and a limousine, you can draw your own. Thank you for him. Now, one other point I have to make with you tonight has to do with the fact that we're putting a man on the moon, if not on the bus. And this gentleman is going to be sent. Are you aware of this? Well, see, President Kennedy knew that we had to go to the moon, and that's why he didn't spend too much time with Shepard, but a lot of people didn't understand that. And they kept saying, well, geez, awfully cold. That's what the press thought, because when he had Alan Shepard there, you remember, he dropped the medal, and then he picked it up and he said, here. And Shepard got it, and it was sort of like, you did very well for someone who isn't in the family. And so, you see, if it wasn't comparative, you'd all be happy with the way the president behaved, but this Russian thing is leading to insanity. Because people say, well, after all, Khrushchev kissed Gagarin, which is true. Now you have to ask, does he respect them? That's what's really important. There's no standards to apply to this. we have, I think we're moving ahead in a very positive fashion nationally. Do you know we broke down a great deal of bigotry, a wall of bigotry by the election of the president himself in his faith area, which was an American precedent. And then after that, we have two members of the Jewish faith in the cabinet. And I read in a national magazine recently that the new director of the budget is of the Jewish faith. And it says that he had no idea, first generation, and his parents came here from Europe 20 years ago. He was running errands at their grocery store in the Lower East Side. And he had no idea that one day he'd be totaling our national budget on a brown paper bag. That's what's at the bottom of the article. Now, one other word to tell you about, and that has to do with dignity. Did any of you see the Academy Awards ceremony? Well, I want to congratulate everybody involved with it, because I think it was exceptionally dignified. I was about to be on it, but my material was not acceptable. And I'd like to admit that I think what I was doing was not correct. I had a kind of a, well, it isn't much of a routine, isn't worth mentioning, about if President Kennedy, Luella Parsons once mentioned that President Kennedy could be a movie star, he's handsome enough. And this had to do with Alfred Hitchcock making a picture with Kennedy, like North by Northwest. And instead of Cary Grant, they have President Kennedy with the same ending. He's pursued by the villains across Mount Rushmore, but in this instance, he's climbing on his own face. That was the routine. And I didn't think it fit either. We felt that it didn't have dignity. So I went home and watched the Academy Awards ceremony, which I'm sure you all saw, which had a lot of dignity, such as the best performance by an actress, Elizabeth Taylor in Butterfield 8, portraying a girl who lived by her wits. The best supporting performance, Shirley Jones and Elmer Grantry, portraying a girl who lived by her wits. Best art direction, The World of Susie Wong, who was the girl who, right? So you all saw it. And the best song, Never on Sunday. I'd like to sum up the movie industry's contribution by calling it something for the whole family.